Welcome to Leader IAS in association with Suhas Academy, Navi Mumbai. Myself, Professor Suhas Sargar. Today, in this audiobook, we are all going to learn the State Board of Maharashtra, Standard 9th, Subject History and Political Science, Chapter Number 5, Education. So let's begin. In this chapter, we shall review the main stages and the scheme in the development of the educational system in India. We shall take into consideration primary, secondary, as well as the higher education and beside research institute in some representative areas. This will give us an idea of the educational system throughout the country. The first census of independent India in 1951 revealed the extreme complexity and interactivity and interactability of the educational issues in the country. In the first census, the literacy level was 17%. It rose as shown below. Census year and literacy in box. 1971, literacy is 34%. 1981, the literacy 43%. 1991, literacy 52%. 2001, literacy 64%. Improving the percentage was a serious challenge for the government of India. Several remedial schemes were put in place to deal with it. Primary education. Primary education refers to the schooling given to the children in the 6 to 14 years of age group. In 1988, the central government started a scheme for the spread of primary education and to improve educational standard. It is known as Operation Blackboard. The government made the funds available to help improve the standard of the schools and to fulfill the minimum educational needs, such as at least the two proper classrooms, toilets, one of the two teachers to be female, a blackboard, maps, laboratory apparatus, a small library, a playground, sport equipments, etc. This scheme helped the primary education system to gain some momentum. In box, do you know? After the formation of Maharashtra state in 1960, the government took the decision to implement the common statewide curriculum for standard 1st to 7th. Principal Syed Rauf of the ST College, Mumbai, was assigned the task of preparing the draft of this curriculum. Box is over. In 1994, the scheme was expanded and provision was made for an additional classroom and for appointing one more teacher in the school. With the enrollment of more than 100 students, with the priority given to the girls' school, schools with a majority of the scheduled caste and tribes, students and schools in rural areas, it was also made binding upon the state government to appoint the female teachers to 50% of the post in schools. Again, in 1994, the district primary education program was started with the objective of universalization of primary education. It was implemented in the 7 states, including Maharashtra. The plan envisaged 100% attendance in the primary schools, arresting student dropout, education for girls and for physically handicapped. It included the program such as research on and evaluation of primary education, alternative education, creating societal awareness, etc. The midday meal scheme was started in 1995 to provide the proper nourishment for the students. In box, can we achieve this? In 1991, Kerala became fully literate state. What step must be taken to achieve the 100% literacy in Maharashtra as well? Box is over. In box, do you know Tarabai Modak began work in the field of education in Bordi and Kosbad? She started Anganwadis for Adivasi children. She worked hard to bring in the learning by doing method. To start Kuranshala, the middle school, and to spread the vocational technical education, Anutai Vag established an institution at Kosbad for the progress of Adivasis in Thane district. It is known as a Kosbad project. She started the creches, nurseries, primary school, adult education classes, Bal Sevika training school, etc. for the education of Adivasis. Box is over. See the picture of Maulana Azad. Leader IAS in association with Yashas Academy, Navi Mumbai, myself, Professor Suhas Sargar. Secondary education. After independence, education ministers Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad decided to bring about fundamental changes in the field of education. The University Education Commission was set up for these purposes. This commission recommended the appointment of separate commission for secondary education. Accordingly, in 1952-53, the Mudaliar Commission was appointed. At that time, the pattern of education consisted of 11 plus 4 years for the first degree and 11 plus 1 plus 3 years. The work of the commission. The commission studied secondary education, the nature of curriculum, medium of instruction, teaching methodology, and made the certain recommendation. This commission proposed the concept of higher secondary education. However, it was found difficult to implement it all over the country. In box, do you know Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education was established on the 1st of January 1966 at Pune. This board conducts the school leaving examination of Standard 10 and Standard 12. The board also published the periodical called Shikshan Sankraman. Box is over. The Kothari Commission in 1964, a commission was appointed under the chairmanship of Dr. D.S. Kothari. Dr. J.P. Naik made a valuable contribution of the work of this commission. The commission also recommended the 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern for secondary, higher secondary and university education. This system was implemented for 1972. The commission also suggested a uniform national system of education. The inclusion of mother tongue, Hindi and English in education, as well as continuing education, adult education, education by correspondence, and open universities, and make education trickle down to the lowest rungs of society. It also recommended the increased provision in the budget for expenditure neglected sections like caste and tribes. See the picture of J.P. Naik. See the picture of D.S. Kothari. Maharashtra government adopted the 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern in 1972 and conducted the first standard 10 board exam in 1975. Objective of education according to the Kothari Commission. Objectives of education: social and national integration, modernization of education, nature of social, moral, spiritual values, nurture of social, moral, spiritual values, education and productivity, securing and strengthening of democracy, etc. Higher education. Education in the post-independence era. After independence in 1948, the central government appointed the University Education Commission, whose chairman was Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. Its function included the financial grants, the standard of the universities and their coordinations. See the picture of Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. Method of functioning. The commission accepted the 5-year plan method. It began to sanction and disperse the grants to the universities on behalf of the government. The commission undertakes planning of university education, coordination of syllabi, giving primary to the national needs, primacy to national needs through education, and the planning and implementation of various schemes of higher education. It has done valuable work in establishing University Development Councils, Center for Advanced Studies for Postgraduate Education, establishing new universities after the advent of television in India. It initiated the countrywide classroom programs, which is telecast by the Doordarshan on behalf of the Commission. In box, do you know the art of department was established in 1965 in Maharashtra to frame the policy for art education and for its implementation by institutes of art. This department undertook the responsibility of organizing the drawing grade examination at school level. National Council of Education, Research and Training, that is NCERT. Leader IS in association with Yashas Academy, myself, Professor Suhas Sargar. This body was established in Delhi on the 1st of September 1961. Its main objective is to help the central government in matters of school education in the context of comprehensive policy and in implementing educational scheme. The NCERT was given the responsibility of educational research and development, training, extension, educational programs, restructuring of school curriculum and textbook. It has played a central role in designing the school curricula and textbook with the cooperation of Central Board of Secondary Education. It provides guidance and cooperation in the area of primary and secondary education to the state government. It has been involved in designing the workbooks and handbooks for teachers, in teachers' training, in developing teaching learning techniques, and conducting the talent search examination at the national level. SCERTs were established in all states on the lines of NCERT. The Maharashtra State Council of Educational Research and Training was established in Pune. This institute performs the various functions such as improving the standards of primary education, in service training of teachers, training in the areas of syllabi and evaluation, vocational guidance for the student after the standard 10 and standard 12 exams, and other educational functions. These institutions is known as the academic authority. It bring about periodicals called Jeevan Shikshan. Leader IS in association with Yashas Academy Navi Mumbai, myself Professor Suhas. In box, do you know the Maharashtra State Bureau of Textbook Production and Curriculum Research, Bal Bharati, was established in Pune on 27 January 1967. Bal Bharati prepares the textbook for school children. Textbooks are made in 8 languages, namely Marathi, Hindi, English, Urdu, Kannada, Sindhi, Gujarati and Telugu. Kishore, a monthly magazine for children, is also published by Bal Bharati. National Policy on Education 1986. According to this policy, the certain changes of a fundamental nature were brought about in primary, secondary and higher secondary education in keeping with the changing needs of society. Under this policy, a common core curriculum was framed for all state. The expectation is that by these means all students in India will get equal educational opportunity. There is a scope in the national curriculum for individual state to bring in flexibility in accordance with their cultural, geographical and historical needs. The primary education curriculum in 1988 was prepared on the basis of plan of action designed at the national level for the effective implementation of the National Policy on Education 1986. In box, do you know the competency-based primary education curriculum 1995? Even as the primary education curriculum 1988 was being implemented, a committee was formed at the national level with the Dr. R.H. Dhave as its chairman. to determine minimum level of learning. The Dave Committee developed the charts of minimum level of learning in language, mathematics, and environmental studies up to the standard 5th. The charts show the sequence of learning of the competencies mean for each class. Use of satellite. In 1975, the India met with the success in its attempts to use the satellite for the purpose of education. Eknath Chitnis, a scientist with ISRO, play an important role in it. See the picture of EduSat satellite. Site: Satellite Instructional Television Experiment was undertaken for educational purposes under the leadership of the Space Application Centers at the Ahmedabad. The concept of satellite education came out of these experiments. America had helped India in this program. The program helped to make the provisions for a good standard of education in rural area. Indira Gandhi National Open University, that means IGNU. Leader IS in association with Yashas Academy, Navi Mumbai, myself, Professor Suhas Sargar. This open university was established with the objective that the stream of education should make its own way, its a way into every average household of the country. The United Nations had declared 1970 as the International Education Year. In the same year, a seminar was organized in New Delhi on the subject of open university by the Government of India Departments of Education and Social Welfare, Information and Broadcasting, University Grant Commission, along with UNESCO. The idea of establishing an open university evolved in this seminar. In 1974, the government appointed a committee under the chairmanship of P. Parthasarathy, and the open university took shape on 20 September 1985. In accordance with these recommendations and the suggestion, it was named after the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. In box, find out. The Yashwantrao Chavan, the Maharashtra Mukta Vidyapeeth, was established in Nashik in 1989. Find out about this open university with the help of internet. Those who are unable to get a college education in the formal way are given the concession of eligibility criteria, age and other conditions for admission to these university. In 1990, the IGNU started an audio-visual distance education program through Akashvani and Doordarshan. It conducted more than 1,000 curricula of various branches. It provides the facility for education through 58 training centers in the country and 41 centers in foreign countries. Research Institute Science. In the post-independence period in 1950, the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that means CSIR, was established with the objective of to promote scientific research in the country and to take the benefits of research to all the people. Research began in the fields like physics, chemistry, pharmaceutical, food processing and mining. In order that industry benefits from these research, contracts were signed with the industrial institutes that helped to reduce our imports and save the foreign currency. These institutes also motivated the fundamental research. The laboratories of the council also play an important part in bringing back to the country students who had gone abroad for higher education. The achievement of the CSIR includes making the ink used for marking voters' fingers during election, medicines for malaria, elephantiasis and tuberculosis, water purification technology, reduction in the time required for bamboo production. It also used the DNA fingerprinting for the first time in India. Conducted a genetic study of the Adivasis of Andamans and proved that those tribes are 60,000 years old and developed the earthquake early warning system. It also played an important role in the use of neem as a pesticide, use of turmeric for healing wounds, and in the case of patents for various varieties of rice. The CSIR has prepared a digital encyclopedia of Indian traditional knowledge and made it available in 8 international languages. Leader IS, in association with Yashas Academy, Navi Mumbai, Maharashtra. Mathematics, the National Institute for Research in the Mathematical and Physical Sciences in Tamil Nadu was established in 1962. It encouraged the highest level of research in mathematics. Computers. In 1969, we made the first indigenous computer named ISIJU. Computers, as this was achieved by the Indian Statistical Institute and Jadavpur University working together. In 1974, Tata Consultancy Service, TCS, obtained an American contract in the area of software production, and that was beginning of the software industry in India. Computer also helped to step up the speed of scientific research. In 1987, America refused to allow the India to get a supercomputer. The Rajiv Gandhi government decided to develop a supercomputer indigenously in 1988. The central government established the Center for Development for Advanced Computing in CDAC, that is CDAC, CDAC, in Pune. And in 1991, the center under the leadership of Dr. Vijay Bhatkar developed the Param 8000 supercomputer. Bhabha Atomic Research Center, that is BARC. The institute has conducted the valuable research in the field of nuclear physics, solid state physics, spectroscopy, chemical and life sciences. It also started a school to train the scientists for setting up nuclear reactors. Engineering. Indian Institute of Technology, that means IIT. India's first IIT was set up at Kharagpur in West Bengal in 1951. The objective of these institute was that higher and advanced education in all branches of engineering should be available in India and meet the country's needs. The engineering college at Powai, Chennai, Kanpur and New Delhi were converted into IITs. The Soviet Union's, America, Germany and the UNESCO also extended help to set up these institutes. The IITs in India were given the status of demand universities, deemed universities, and BTech and MTech courses were started there. Admission through entrance exam, nominal fees, and reservation for students are the special features of the IIT institutions. In the decade from 1970 to 1980, a large number of IIT students began to leave for the foreign countries, causing the brain drain crisis. However, these institutions or these situation changes after 1990. IIT were also established at Guwahati, Assam in 1994 and in Roorkee in 2001. Indian Institute of Management. As the high quality engineers were graduating from the IITs, the center and the Gujarat government started the Indian Institute of Management to mold skill managers. Harvard Business School in America helped to set up the IIM Ahmedabad. Other IIMs have been set up at Kolkata, Bengaluru, Lucknow, Kozhikode, Indore and Shillong. In POX, do you know, systematic training in any aspect of film making is given at the Film and Television Institute of India. Facilities were made available for imparting scientific training at this institute in all aspects of filmmaking, such as direction, editing, and acting. The institute inherited the legacy of the Prabhat Film Company of Pune and become famous all over the world, box over. National Institute of Design. This institute was established in Ahmedabad in 1961 for the purpose of imparting training in industrial design. Courses in basic design, graphic design, product design, visual communication were started in 1963-64. The work done by these institutes includes designing of the transistors, radio and the calculator and the logos of Indian Airlines and the State Bank of India. Leader IAS, in association with Yashas Academy, Navi Mumbai, under the guidance of Professor Suhas Sargar. Research Institute and Medicines. In the post-independence period in 1949, the Indian Council for Medical Research, that is ICMR, was established for conducting the research in the medical field. It was given the responsibility for cooperating with the universities, medical colleges, government and non-government research institutes, and giving them guidance and financial support for research activities. 26 centers were started in different parts of the country for research on various diseases. The research has made it possible to control tuberculosis and leprosy. All India Institute of Medical Science, that is AIIMS, was established to give the further impetus to advance education and research in medicine. It was given the responsibility to undergraduate and postgraduate courses in medicine. Colleges for undergraduate and postgraduate education in the most branches of the medicines, good research facilities and the well-equipped hospitals are the significant features of this institute. The institutes also provide the medical treatment to the common people at nominal rates. It has established special colleges for training in nursing and super specialty centers for treatment of disorders of the heart, brain and eyes. For further development of the medical field, the Medical Council of India was restructured in 1958 and was entrusted with the task of determining the criteria for quality of medical education, its supervision and inspections. These institutions have the responsibility of conducting the research on various diseases, developing test and standardization of medicine. In box, do you know? In 1969, the Central Council for Research in Indian Medicines and Homeopathy was established to conduct research and bring about development in the Ayurvedic, Naturopathy, Unani, and Homeopathy systems of medicine. In 1979, this institute was dissolved and replaced by the three others, namely Central Council for Research in Unani Medicines, Central Council for Research in Homeopathy, Central Council for Research in Yoga, Nature Cure, in accordance with their respective clinical methodologies. Box is over. Cancer Research. The Advanced Center for Treatment, Research and Education in Cancer is a branch of the Tata Memorial Center. It functions as the National Center for Treatment, Research and Education in relation to cancer. Research Institutes, Agriculture. In India, the research in agriculture had begun as early as 1905. The Indian Agriculture Research Institute was given the status of a university in 1958, and work began in departments such as development of agricultural sectors, research, well-equipped laboratories, soil sciences, agriculture sciences, economic botany, and other departments. Research also began on wheat, pulses, oil seeds, vegetables, and many other problems. Its most significant achievement is the fundamental research it has conducted on the methods of taking multiple crops in a year, which had been a great benefit to the farmers. The institutes maintain a library at its head office in Delhi, which is the biggest agricultural related library in the country. In the next chapters, we shall study laws related to the woman, women's contribution and the role of the government with respect to other weaker sections of the society. That's all about this chapter. This chapter's audiobook is from Leader IAS in association of Yashas Academy, Navi Mumbai, Professor Suhas Sargar.